finally.
Thank you. Nice to be here.
Congrats on this movie, because you are getting really great reviews for this.
Thank you. Yeah, we've been so grateful for the response to it. You know, it was a 4-year struggle getting it made. We just
really?
Were really lucky to be coming out now. Yeah.
Well, and you're very busy too. We're going to get to everything that you've been to. So what attracted you to this project? Because you got so much going on.
I read the script 4 years ago when I was still in college. And
here in New York.
Here in New York at NYU. Yeah. Yeah, the city that I now call home.
Yeah.
And it was the result of a creative day between our writer and our director, who knew this guy who taught English in Korea a long time ago, a friend of theirs, who was sort of out of his depth romantically and a fish out of water, but really cared about his job. And so we came up with a story about this guy who means really well and is a good teacher, but finds it necessary for him to teach sex ed and these kids going through puberty and everything, but he isn't so experienced himself.
Right.
So we get a lot of comedy from that.
Informative.
Yeah, we're accurate.
Well, as Sarah mentioned, you do have a lot going on, including the upcoming Entourage movie, where, unlike a lot of celebrities who play themselves in the film, you auditioned for this role. You're playing a character.
Yeah, I'm sort of what you would call an antagonist, and a really fun, kind of nasty character who causes them some trouble. And,
against type.
There's a lot of great cameos in the movie. I called the director, creator Doug Ellen, the anti-paparazzo, or the inverse paparazzo, because famous people don't leave him alone. His phone is always blowing up with particularly singers and sports people going, put me in it. So there's a lot of great cameos in it, but I'm a new character. Billy Bob Thornton plays my dad. It's a really fun
movie. And you like playing the non-nice guy, right?
Yeah, I mean, you don't get the, you know, when I was working as a kid in films, you don't really get to play a lot of 12-year-old
villains.
Or, you know, guys like that. So the opportunity has presented itself a lot in the past 2 years. You know, with Spoils of Babylon, which is a ridiculous character in its own right.
Well, you've been working with Kevin Smith, too. You were, did a horror film last year. Was it last year, right? With Tusk?
Yes, it came out a couple months ago, yeah.
Oh, a couple months ago.
Or 2 months ago, yeah. But Tusk got to play sort of a podcaster in Kevin's mode there. And then he cast all of us again in a completely different movie that happens parallel to Tusk, called Yoga Hosers, where I play a Nazi. So very against type.
Alone.
Yeah.
It's a lot of fun, Yoga Hosers.
Yeah.
Well, you mentioned acting as a kid, and most people still remember you from your role in The Sixth Sense. I mean, does that bug you trying to, or are you trying to get away from it? I'm sure you are.
I think, when you get older and people have a really a concrete image in their mind of you, you know, it's not, I'm not trying necessarily to shatter that, because those are films I'm proud of,
yeah.
But it is fun that, yeah, as you sort of go and you try and do a bunch of different things and everything, it's still sort of jarring in people's minds, so, you
I'm
know.
Like, aren't you?
It probably will be for some time, but, you know, by next year with all this stuff coming out, I think people will probably be more familiar with the things I'm doing now.
Let's talk about The Spoils of Babylon for a minute. It's a parody series. It's like a great cast, too. It's Tim Robbins and Tobey Maguire, and what can you tell me about that, and is it coming back?
I don't know for sure, but I know that that group of people, which was insane that they assembled a team like that, Will Ferrell and Kristen Wiig in addition.
Oh, yes, and them as well.
You know, I just know that they all get along really well, and we all had a blast doing it, so I don't know if there's going to be future versions. But yeah, it's just the sense of humor of those guys, Andrew Steele and Matt Piedmont, who wrote and directed it. It's just, I remember one story he told me, Andrew Steele found a mannequin in a barn, and he was like, I just cast one role to Matt Piedmont. I'm like, that's the sort of wavelength these guys are kind of on in making this. So yeah, I would make that show all year round. I had a blast.
Well, we know you're going to do some things behind the scenes in your career down the road. You know, you said that you admire Ron Howard and Jodie Foster and folks like that who are also child actors. Are we going to see you on the Broadway stage, though, eventually?
I did that once in 2008. We didn't run for very long, but I did American Buffalo with John Leguizamo and Cedric the Entertainer.
How'd you like it?
I had a blast. I would love to go back and do it again. I studied experimental theater at NYU, and I loved that environment. Walking to work at a theater in New York is sort of like my favorite thing in the world.
Yeah.
So yeah, definitely love
that. Well, hopefully we get to see you on Broadway.
Cool.
Soon.
Definitely.
Thanks so much for stopping by.
Thank
and
you.
Sex Ed hits theaters and on demand this Friday. So be sure to check it out.
Thank you.
Thank you for being here. Nice to meet you.
And still ahead, fashion expert Jacque Safford reveals her 3 favorite new ways to wear flats this season. And it's the latest mugshot.